Good morning, praise the Lord. Welcome again. We thank God for you and we thank God for this day that God has given to us. Shall we pray as we get started? Thank you, Father. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you, amazing God, because you are faithful. This day, my Father, we honor you. Thank you, Father, for giving us an opportunity to share your word amongst ourselves. And this day, Father, we thank you because, Lord, you're going to guide us. May you guide our paths. Make our path straight today, O Father. As this word comes to us, O Father, may it, King of Glory, have a seed that shall, my Father, germinate and have an impact in our lives. For this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So I want to welcome you to this session. Yesterday we had session one or episode one of Turning Temptations into Triumph. And today we are doing the second episode of how can we turn our temptation into triumph. And yesterday we looked at how Christ was able to, you know, challenge the disciples and tell them to, you know, watch and pray. And today I want us just to dip right into it as we look at how do we overcome temptations, and basically how does even temptation come anyway. And that will help us now to have an understanding on how do we overcome temptation in case we are tempted, in case we find ourselves in situations which are compromising. How do we get ourselves out of it? And first of all, even before we get to that, how do we even ensure that we don't get into those scenarios so that we are not, tempted to that extent? And just look at the Matthew 26:41. One thing that was very evident was the best way to look at temptation is to pray, or rather to overcome temptation is to pray and seek God. And just basically how temptations come. You know, James 1:13, it gives us understanding on how temptations come. And we know yesterday, as I say, no temptations come from God. The devil always brings temptation so that he can draw us away from God. Praise the Lord. Any temptation is a result of what is in you. Are we together? Any temptation is as a result of what is in you. Yesterday we say that Satan will always, you know, try and look at our weaknesses and our weak points so that he can be able to bring us down using those weak areas. And, you know, as we go to have this understanding, you know, temptations come from different things. Yesterday we saw, you know, if you're in a compromising situation, we saw lust is one of the areas that people are tempted through. People are tempted through money. People are tempted through, you know, opportunities that come very fast. And all these are what we find ourselves in situations which we might not get ourselves out of if we're not very careful. Now, what is inside you is actually what the devil uses. And that's why we say it, once the devil entices you with those things, when he puts, it's like he entices you with all these temptations, then he's able to win you very easily so that he can disgrace you and he takes you away from God. Now, temptation leads to deception. Once you're tempted, you have tendency of being deceptive, because then the devil will always lie. And we know in the book of John 10:10 says, well, the devil comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And once he steals your mind, he steals your thoughts, he steals everything that is around you, then he's able to bring you down and manipulate you. You know, he's a master of manipulation. He can manipulate you all the years, and you find yourself not even moving, you're stagnating, you're not advancing in your areas of sphere. Why? Because he knows your weakness. Now, some people cannot go to the next level because of temptation. And those levels you're looking at, maybe it's about a career. And most likely you find, because of lust, you're looking for a job. Then you get a job very fast, but this job does not come in the right way. So once you go through those, you know, back doors, maintaining this job becomes very hard because you got it in the wrong way in the first place. And that's why you find now this job becomes, you know, a bother to you. You're not enjoying this employment because how you got it was in the wrong way. And that's why you find now the devil will use that. You know, the devil always wants to see an opening. Once there's an opening, he will use that to bring you down. He will use any gateway to make sure that you are down and you're not going to advance in those things that God has planned in you. And yesterday we looked at how, you know, the devil always makes sure that our destinies and our purposes are done what? Are closed and shattered so that we cannot advance. After you overcome temptation, the Holy Spirit comes into you. Now, the best way when you say that, you keep watching and pray, because when you pray, you avoid. Look at this scenario. If you're just about to get yourself into temptation and you pray, the best way, when you pray, the Holy Spirit quickens you and quickens your spirit not to do that thing that you were just about to do. And that's where the importance of prayer comes in. And that is where we need to rely on the Holy Spirit more for this kind of this time that we are living in. When you act upon the guidance of the Holy Spirit, then you are able to overcome temptations so easily. And we're looking at Dr. Talk prayer, it will make you sensitive. You know, prayer makes you sensitive, it gives you wisdom, and therefore you become more sensitive to your environment, what the environment looks like, your friends, the people around you. Then you are able now to overcome temptation. And prayer makes you, you know, sensitive. Sensitivity in matters of spiritual alertness, so that nothing will be able to come against you that is not aware about. Remember, by the way, there's nothing that comes to us as a surprise. Everything was actually seen in the spiritual realm before it became physical. So nothing is a surprise. So anything that comes to you, it was there, but you're not very alert to understand it. Or rather, you're not very sensitive in prayer. And that's why it's important for us to pray and ensure that we are guided on God's word. Praise the name of Jesus. Now, reading the word of God also makes you very sensitive. I don't think you read the word of God and still watch pornographic movies. I don't think you'll be able to keep praying and maintain that relationship with God and still do other bad contents, because the word of God will actually guide you. It helps us. And you know what? The word of God is a voice of God. So it speaks to us over and over and over. And the word of God, again, is the truth. The Bible says that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. So the word of God will be able to give you the truth about the word. It guides you. It helps you to understand how you need to live this life without having temptations. Now, avoid environments which can lead you to sin. When you do that, you are able to easily go to the directions which are the right directions, and you will avoid places where you'll find yourself in sin. Have boundaries, you know, in your life and around your environment. You know, some people are very hard to say, this is my stand. They always want to please people, they always want to sympathize, and that's why you find yourself in scenarios where you can't be able to control yourself. Please say no. The Bible says, let your no be no, and let your yes be yes. If you're saying no, let it be mean that no. If you're saying yes, let it be a yes. You need to stand your ground as a Christian, as a believer, as a child of God. Once you stand your ground, you are able now to, you know, overcome many things that can put you in a place which will lead you into temptation. Now, don't give the flesh an opportunity. The Bible says that do not give the devil a chance. When you give the flesh an opportunity, it comes to manipulate you. And that's where the book of Galatians, we look at Galatians 5, and verses, that should be Galatians 5, just a moment. Galatians 5 and verse 17. So Galatians 5, 17, the Bible says this. 17, I read, that is NIV. For the flesh desires what is contrary to the spirit. For the flesh desires what is contrary to the spirit, and the spirit what is contrary to the flesh. They are in conflict with each other, so that you are not to do whatever you want. So understand this, that every time the spirit and the flesh are at war. That's why sometimes you have to pray, you can't pray. Sometimes you have to fast, you can't fast. The Bible tells you, let's eat. The spirit tells you, let's pray. So you need to actually control this by ensuring that you are standing on the guidance of the word of God. If you're able to overcome the flesh, because this is your flesh, overcome it and let the flesh listen to your guidance, and you're going to guide the flesh. Once you're able to stand that ground, then you are able to win the battle against the flesh, because all these things come as a result of pleasing the flesh. Many times you want to please the flesh, you know, want to entice the flesh, and we find ourselves in situations which we can't get ourselves out of it. To continue on this, no temptation has overtaken you except what is common to mankind.
Okay? And God is faithful. He will not let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. Hallelujah. Acts 1 Corinthians 10 verse 13. God cannot let you be tempted beyond what you can bear. You have the capacity, you have the will, you have the strength, you have the choice to tell the body, hey body, today is fasting. Hey body, today is praying. Hey body, today is reading the word of God. Today is not watching TV, today we're reading the word of God. Once you are able to do these kind of things, then temptations will not come unto you. You're able to overcome it very easily. Praise the name of Jesus. Now, we have an advantage over the enemy, because the enemy, when it comes to steal, you actually stand your ground because you know what the word of God says. You know what God speaks about your life. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, overcoming temptation also means distancing yourself from certain things. You know, there's some things, basically, if you just find yourself in it, you will find yourself tempted, and you have to avoid those things. For instance, if you're watching a movie and you're just alone, and you know maybe you're a single person, or you're not dating, or you're with a female or a male gender, and you guys are just maybe friends, you'll find yourself tempted. And as you continue watching this and having compromise, because the flesh, you know, has desires. If you don't control yourself by avoiding certain things, you'll actually find yourself in that situation. It will be very hard to you. So remove all materials, remove all contents that can be able to make you get tempted. Praise Jesus. Stop watching explicit movies. Stop conversations that can actually be flattened, so that you can find yourself, you are getting to places where your mind is thinking different things and negative things, which will lead you to sin. Avoid anything that powers lust. And you see, lust is one of the things that we'll find ourselves into. And young people who are also watching this, please make your mind a haven of the things of God. Yesterday I quoted the book of Romans 12, and I say, Bible says, well, I beseech you, brethren, by the mercies of God, present yourselves as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable. For this is the true form of worship. Sometimes when we present ourselves, you know, in other ways, and that's when the devil has a way. When the devil knows you love pornography, that is the doorway he will use. If he knows you love money, that is the doorway he will use. If he knows you love, you know, corruption, that is the way he's going to use. Please be very careful about closing the doors that the enemy can use, and you will triumph, you will be successful, you will win, you will have a victorious life, because you are able to overcome temptation. God will not allow you to go through what you can't bear. This morning, as we conclude this topic about temptations versus triumph, I want to challenge you again. The word of God is very clear. Read the word of God. Ensure that you're close to your men of God who can help you and walk with you. Ensure that you're reading the content which are able to even give your minds, you know, positive thoughts. Remember, you're also going to be around environment which is going to help you overcome those things. And I can tell you for a fact, you will triumph over temptation. The Lord bless you so much. Again, I want to pray with you. Maybe you never joined us yesterday and you're just wondering, what is this topic we're talking about? We are saying avoid temptation, because the only way to do that is to endure, resist, and overcome temptation, and God is going to be with you. God loves you so much, and he wants us to live a life that is going to please him. Please make sure your relationship with God is right. We are living in times where many things are happening in this world. People are killing each other. Death is no longer just like any those things that we used to think that will not happen to us. Everything is happening so fast. We have diseases which are coming to us which we can't even, like COVID-19. No one knew about COVID-19. But the only way out of this is to embrace God. Let God be a reason for you to live, that you have a reason that tomorrow, in case of anything, I know I have a place that I will enjoy eternity because God is with you. I want to thank you so much for watching. Thank you for joining us. I want us to pray with you. Just believe God. Maybe you are there, not born again, and you're wondering, God, how can I, you know, avoid this temptation by giving my life unto you? The best way is salvation. Once you're born again, you're also empowered, because salvation is a doorway to heaven. Once you're saved, then the Holy Spirit now helps you to avoid this thing and able to navigate through this thing properly. Let's pray with you this morning. Once, if you're not born again, please just say these words, you know, after me, and we shall pray with you. Say, Lord Jesus, I come before you. I choose you today as my Lord and Savior. Father, forgive my sins. Write my name in the book of life. Today I'm born again. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. You're not born again. As you speak those words, please go to a church or see a pastor who will be able to guide you and will praise in the Spirit. And I know your life will be the same again. Let's pray. Thank you, Father. Thank you, King of Glory. Thank you for this opportunity. We have listened to your word, temptations versus triumph. Anytime, Lord, we are tempted, Father, we are able to get out because nothing we can't bear because we know you are with us. Today, my Father, I thank you for everyone who has joined us. You have given us this topic, my Father, to understand and even get to grow in your word. We know we will triumph and we shall be successful against every temptation. Nothing shall put us down. Today, I pray for every listener who is joined us today, every person who is watching from afar. Father, King of Glory, may you help them to overcome temptation. Those who are overwhelmed by temptation, Lord, may you help them to overcome. Nothing, my Father, meets with surprise and be able to suppress and even dry every at last. Every drug abuse, Father, everything that my Father, King of Glory, has put us at the sons and daughters, my Father, down, Lord, may they arise again. Because you are God who is full of power, you are full of anointing, my God. And I thank you because today we are free from every chain of darkness, every lust, oh God, from every captivity of the enemy, from every bondage, we are free. And those who are free, my Father, you shall make them free indeed. I thank you because, Lord, this word has given us a reason to move on and be triumphant, oh God, and victorious because you are with us. I thank you. I give you honor and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you so much. Again, thank you for joining us and have a blessed week in Jesus' name.